So you probably shouldn't be calling a meniscal tear on MRI unless you can see the signal abnormality extending to the surface, so either superior surface, inferior surface, or inner free edge, on at least two slices. Those two slices can be in the same plane, two contiguous slices, or you can see one on the sagittal, one on the coronal, okay? So they don't need to be the same plane, but you need to see it twice. If you just see it on one slice, the positive predictive value for medial meniscus is about 40%. For lateral meniscus, it's terrible, 18% that they're gonna have a tear. Whereas if you've got two slices, almost guaranteed that the patient's going to have a tear when they do an arthroscopy. Okay, so use that two slice touch rule for meniscal tears. So now we're gonna go through the different orientation of the tears. So firstly, the horizontal tear, which is cutting through in that kind of axial plane. Most commonly you have a horizontal tear that doesn't create a flap, but occasionally you'll get these horizontal flap tears where they're just an isolated little area and they can flip around into funny spots. So here we have a coronal image, classic horizontal tear. This patient looks like they've got a discoid lateral meniscus. So lateral meniscus would usually come into about here. This one's going in much, much further. So a discoid lateral meniscus, much more likely to develop a tear. Horizontal tear extending from the periphery to the inferior articular surface. It's on way more than two slices. So we're happy to call that a horizontal tear extending to the inferior articular surface. Have a look out the front of this one, and it's associated with a massive parameniscal cyst. So horizontal tears are the ones that tend to form parameniscal cysts. So if you see a parameniscal cyst, think horizontal tear of the meniscus. Horizontal tears are most commonly, or almost always, degenerative. The most common location is that posterior horn of the medial meniscus. You get this linear signal here extending from the periphery to the inferior articular surface. What I want you to take note of, you don't always get a parameniscal cyst, but have a look at the meniscocapsular inflammation, or the synovitis, sitting next to this. See all that? High, smudgy kind of signal there. Have a look on the coronal plane. See all this stuff sitting next to it? It's important to report that, important to say that they're associated localized synovitis, because that suggests the tear is symptomatic. If you have a horizontal tear, a degenerative tear, and there's no synovitis next to it, maybe it's not causing their knee pain and don't need any treatment. But if there's localized synovitis, it probably makes sense that it's causing pain. In this case, it's causing a bit of Pezanserine bursitis as well. You can see that fluid sitting deep to those tendons. Let's have a look on the axial plane. So here we go, sartorius, gracilis, semitendinosus, and there's some fluid sitting in the Pezanserine bursa. So that can be very painful when you get that synovitis, Pezanserine bursitis related to your degenerative horizontal tear of the medial meniscus. So here's another one, degenerative horizontal tear of the posterior horn of medial meniscus, a bit of meniscocapsular inflammation next to it. When we look on the coronals, you can see it extends around into the meniscal body. If you concentrate, you can see that this inferior aspect of it has actually become flipped down into the tibial recess there. And these are really important to spot. Can you see that? It's kind of flipped around on itself and it's sitting down in there. Really important because they're easy to miss because they're small like that. But important because the surgeon doesn't know to stick their probe down there and pull that bit out, because it just looks like a nice inner free edge to them. So you need to specifically say there is a small horizontal flap tear displaced into the tibial recess. And they can flip upwards, they can flip downwards. Often they flip above the posterior root attachment. A little horizontal tear at the back flips up and sits up here.